34-year-old Christine Jarrett of Howard County disappeared back in January of 1991. Almost 21 years later, her remains were finally found on her husband's property, and now 59-year-old Robert Jarrett Jr. is in court facing murder charges. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer has more on the first day of his trial.
More than 21 years after his wife Christine went missing, Robert Jarrett Jr. is being charged with her murder. Police had always suspected Jarrett all along and finally say they have the evidence to prove him guilty.
They want everybody to speculate, to try to conjecture and fill in the pieces without evidence. And that's going to be the biggest problem for the state's case.
George Pesoris, attorney for 59-year-old Robert Jarrett Jr., tells reporters the evidence just isn't there to find his client guilty of murdering his wife, Christine, more than 21 years ago. In opening statements, state prosecutors outline step by step what it says the evidence will show in this case, that the Jarretts married young, had two sons together, that Robert had affairs and was very violent towards his wife, and ultimately, in January of 1991, murdered her, buried her body under a shed in their backyard, and covered it with concrete. The state went on to say police were never able to prove it, though, lacking evidence, that is, until April of 2012, when a second marriage failed and police were able to convince Jarrett's second wife to search the property. Police would find the remains of Christine Jarrett's body under the shed, along with her purse. Jarrett's defense told the jury in its opening statements that there simply was no evidence to convict him of murder, that Christine was also involved with affairs and would threaten to leave her husband constantly, telling friends and neighbors that, quote, one day she was going to walk out and never come back. As far as testimony, a number of neighbors and co-workers were called to the stand and testified about the Jarretts' rocky marriage. The defense, though, still confident after the first day that they feel Robert Jarrett will be found not guilty.
I just let the evidence present itself, and then at the end, 2-3 weeks from now, there'll be no other decision for the jury to make other than finding my client not guilty.
Now, Jarrett is facing charges of first-degree murder, which carries a maximum of life in prison. The trial is expected to take anywhere from the next 2 to 3 weeks. In Ellicott City, I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.